Likatara. Father, in Jesus' name. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, eternal rock of ages, we bless your name. We give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adorations. We thank you because you are our Father. You are our King. You are our only Father. Metekri satando sekia labadosia. I satelia kakakokondo kukelebreteye. O doto rote tende krata ili akakaka detendete. Lusete pelete. Mekreka konde seliandoze. Ili atata belekilata. Uziala tende kratu se tende ruho. Uge ketede brende doduse kedeke. Rete belete kruse ketende krahila ha. Marada gata kakakakakada kata tende roto shule kete kete. Medekrada dotia tata se kete kete. Mere Ketambraka lakrata kalakatata, merekata kiakataka barakatonjia, marata kiatata no de yakato, merekata yakatia kapata kotokoto, merekata hikata katosianaba, melata chutekete, makaka barakato, urokoto, melekrakata, pialatata, rosia bala bakwakatakata, merekata maleto, lusekete, belekraka katikatakata, melekatikata, malato. Undeto, melatundato, malatandata, malatandata, malatikete, malosende krako humbelete, bratu sepetekete, marokotumbele, isatabala, intapalaba, iselekete, meletikata, mehatatatata, marokotumbele, itayikata, maroto suakata palakata, meratatuata, merikapalapa, Ipatatuasakete, mele pratatuasata, mehapa kabalaba, malika tatada, mohu, itakata barakada, malasia tata, ikata palatia kata, mato setekete, melika palakasianda polika sanda posianda. Everlasting Father, we say thank you, Jesus, for this powerful program, because you are going to take perfect control this morning in the name of Jesus. We hereby welcome you into the message, and we ask you, Holy Spirit, to speak out yourself in the name of Jesus. We come against all hindrances in every areas. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. You are in the service right now. This is our Sabbath service. Our Sabbath service. Yeah, the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. Yeah. Now, the topic of our assignment today is called the will of the Father. The will of the Father. The will of the Father. It is so pity that many Christians did not even understand what the Bible means by the will of the Father. The will of the Father. The Lord will bless you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You and I will not end in hell in Jesus' name. The will of the Father. The will of the Father. Why is the will of the Father so important in the Bible? Why did Jesus Christ refer to the will of the Father? Why is this so important that the will of the Father must be done? Many Christians have been hearing the will of the Father, you know, they read it in the Bible, they never understand the deep reasons or the mystery behind that will. When Joseph was in time of convictions, he was passing through temptations, serious temptations. powerful temptations that the woman of his master, the woman have to drag his clothes and say, come here, sleep with me. Commit adultery with me. The woman was a very beautiful woman. I never see the woman, but I know that, you know, she will be beautiful because Egyptian people are always beautiful. And number two, as a wife of a Potiphar will have chosen a most beautiful because they allow them, anybody that is in a realm of the, you know, in the higher realm, they allow them to choose a virgin and a very beautiful lady. So I know that the wife of that Potiphar was a very beautiful woman. Very clean, very pure, so seductive, so wonderful that, you know, so clean. But this is a young man who has the ability and the grace to sleep with his master's wife without anybody knowing at all. The Bible says Potiphar has given him the audacity, has given him the power, has given him the capacity to take and to handle his house. He gave him everything to handle except his wife. So he can easily say that all of you, all the servants, is the head of the servant. So he can say, all of you, you can go and walk outside there and never come inside until I rang the bell for you to come inside. So, not in these days that when a master will tell a servant not to do something, and the servant will say, what did he mean? I will go and do it. No, in those days, when their master said, do this, you must do it. If you don't do it, you are in trouble. So then he can easily tell them that go and walk, never enter the house. If I see you enter the house, you are in trouble. And I believe they will have obeyed him and that they will have been walking outside. He can easily, you know, say, sister, he can say, madam, what do you say now? And sleep with the madam. Have intercourse with her, enjoying as herself, do everything, defy the bed, everything like that. Without anybody knowing at all. Even Potiphar will not know. But there is one thing I want you to understand. Joseph never did that. He never did that. He mentioned something, even at the point of his serious temptations, when the wife was on the bed and he said, Joseph, come and help me to do something. And he came there. The wife dragged the clothes. Put him onto herself so that Joseph can sleep on his chest, on her chest. Probably sleep on her chest, start having intercourse. Joseph said no, he dragged himself to the extent that the cloth that Joseph wear was torn or removed because they were up at there. The word was removed. In it, the woman owed it very well that the way he dragged it, he has to remove it, remaining pint. Joseph had to run out, say something before going. He said, why will I do this and sin against God? That is the point I want to bring out. Sin against God. Now, I begin to look at this point. And I want you to resume your view too. When Jesus Christ, our Lord, came into the world, he said, my Father said, my Father said, my Father said. Everything about Jesus is my Father said, my Father said. Why is the will of the Father so important that Jesus Christ himself is also saying, my Father said, you must be perfect as my Father is perfect. You must be holy as the Father is holy. Why is that Father so important in any matter? Why? It means that, one, if any Christian can be, you know, no matter the kind of anointing you might have, no matter the kind of power you might be possessing, if you did not obey the law of the Father, it means that heaven is not for you. You are an enemy of the Father. If you look from the Bible, from the beginning to the end, the will of the Father was one of the most powerful things ever done. Now, that is what will lead us to scripture. If you open your Bible to Matthew chapter 7. The will of the Father. Matthew chapter 7, verses 21 to 23. I will read from that verse 21. He said, not everyone that seeth unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven, which the earth. Wait there. In that chapter 21, wait. It means that Jesus is not even referring to himself now. He's referring to his Father now. It means you can be calling the name of Jesus, 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 and yet be an enemy of the Father. It means you can be crying out the name of Jesus, Jesus, and yet be the most dangerous being on earth. Because the Father probably did not know you. He said, not all the person that said, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom of heaven. That kingdom of heaven is the may important issue there. But he that doeth the will of the Father. No wonder. The Bible said, if you are reciting our Father who art in heaven, L-O-B your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth. Your will be done on earth as is in heaven. So it means that even in heaven, it is the will of the Father that takes controls. It is not the will of any man, but the will of the Father is the one that takes controls. Is the one that takes controls, the will of the Father. As is in heaven, as it is in heaven, give us these days. Now, it's when, now the fact is this, let your will be done on earth as in heaven. It is when you do the will of the Father that you can now say, give us this day my daily bread. So it means if you have not done the will of the Father, you are more alike like a fool. Now, listen to what he's saying now. He's not even speaking to ordinary people. If this one is speaking to a Christian, a child of God, a born again. Now, he said, many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in your name? Yes, I know. So, in that day, all these prophet of a thing, the prophet you say you are doing, you are prophesying, and it is coming to pass. You say you are a prophetess. You say you are a prophet. You say you are poetry that can see visions. All the pro prophet of a thing. He said that we call him. He said, but we prophesies in your name. Yes. And he said, in your name I've cast out devils, and in your name doeth many wondrous work. So it means that they will all come. And said, in your name, we do this, we do that, we do this, we do that. But the Bible says, he's going to reply to them after they have done these things on earth. 23rd. And then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that walketh iniquity. It means that if you did not obey the Father, Jesus will automatically disown you. Hallelujah. Jesus will automatically do what? disown you. If you refuse to obey the Father, it will automatically say, go, I don't want you. The Father. Why is it so important that it can even affect the eternity of a man? The will of the Father, the love from God, the scriptural God. You see, this means that even you pray for more than 1 hour every day, you pray for 3 hours every day, that does not mean that the Father knows you. Because these people he mentioned here, they prophesy self. They see the vision of heaven. They see the vision of heaven and hell. They tell people what God says. But the Bible says the Father did not even know them. Because they refuse to do the will of God. It is not about he that preached, but by he, it's not about he that listens, but by he who obeyed the word of God. The will of the Father is the word of God. The will of the Father is the act of being loyal to Almighty God. The will of the Father is the art of being truthful to God Almighty. That is the will of the Father. That is the will of the Father. The will of the Father. The will of the Father is the atmosphere of you be honoring God. Do you honor God? Question. We are asked to start by 10 today. You are just coming by 10:30. Do you honor God? We are asked to study the scriptures. You never study the scriptures. Do you honor God? You spend your money lavishly. You spend everything last year. But when it comes to the things of God, you give little. Do you honor God? When you wanted, when they gave you food, they serve you food, and you begin to eat, you forget to pray to that food. Do you honor God? Do you even know that for you not to take God as number one in your life is an act of disrespect? Do you even know that as you are preaching and you are eating, it's a lack of disrespect? Do you even know that as you are preaching now and you are talking to people, roaming about, laughing and jesting during the message is going on? Do you honor God that way? The will of the Father. Jesus Christ was able to fulfill the will of the Father. Even at the point of death, the Bible says when he get to a point and remember what is going to pass through, he said, Father, I pray that let this cup roll over me. When he prayed the prayer, he said, Lord, not my will, but let your will be done. The will of God to be done. When you wanted to get married, did you allow the will of God to come in your life? You choose yourself. You never even want to know about the will of God. When you are walking, do you allow the will of God to walk in your life? No. You know, you don't care about what God says because you feel that you are the owner of yourself. Do you allow the will of God? Do you allow the will of God? When it comes to the areas of doing things that is very paramount in your life, do you talk to God and tell God that, Lord, what is your will on that concerning these things? Do you even say that? No. You rather go and take decision of yourself. You never involve God into your life matter. And you see, you're not God. How will you make heaven? It is not about you saying, Lord, Lord. Lord, I have preached in your word. Lord, I have sung in your word. Lord, I have done it. But he said, he that obeyed the word of God, he that honored the word of God, is he that will be honored. How many of you have honored God? A man of God says something. He's not even a man of God. A Christian. He built many houses. He has many things he has. And he has children. He has he has too much money. He has helped people when he was on earth. He has done many things for God when he was on earth, but when he wanted to die, he told his children, he called them and sit them down. I said, listen to me. I'm only going to give you very little inheritance. Little of my property. Out of 100%, I will give you like 5 or 10%. They say, why? But you are very rich. We believe that your riches will be the one to make us rich. And the man said, no. Go and labor for your riches. He said, the Lord is the owner of my properties. And he said, listen to me, my children. All my properties, I have willed it to the church, to the ministry of God. Let God owe my money. Let he owe my mansions. Let he owe my properties so that I can have something in heaven. And the man died like that. This is a man who honors God. Can you do that? Can you do that? Many of you don't feel like doing anything anyhow. You go out anyhow without even letting God know. Even if God is telling you, sit down, don't go out today, you say, Father, I have to go. The will of the Father. The will of the Father don't always come easily. It always comes in the hard way. The will of the Father always comes in the hard way. When my father, when God told me that I'm not going to go to school, going to go to university, I said, Lord, but this one is not easy. All my mates are going into university, finishing university in my eye. And you say, I'm not, he said, that is my will for you. I said, it's all right. It's so painful. People talk. People abuse me. My father, even my father talked. People, in fact, they talk, but I stand on my feet because somebody says that he's going to what? Somebody says that what? He said he's going to make me who he wants me to make me to. He said he wants me to obey his way, so I have to obey him. I have to obey him. And later I enter a job. I start doing something to earn money. And God said, it is not my will for you to walk. I wanted to be a full-time. I said, Lord, but I have wife and child. And God said, that is my will for you. Sometimes the will of God is always come in the way that it will take tears from you. I begin to go worry. My life was like a mini, because I don't know where to start from. How will I feed my home? How will I feed my child? How will I feed my wife? When God said, go into full-time. Full-time. No source at all. No source at all. I talked to my wife. My wife said, sir, I will advise you to obey God. I said, are you telling me to obey God? You? How will you eat? He said, let us leave it for God. My wife said, let us leave it for God. I said, oh God. It's so painful anyway. But that is the will of the Father. How many times did God spoken to you and you acting to that word? Because you feel that this thing is too hard for me to do. The will of the Father. And you want to make, how you make it? Do you think God is a partial God? Do you think God is a fool? Do you think God is a mad person that he does not follow his word? He has instructed you in many areas. You never obey. You never obey. Wait, what do you think Abraham was thinking? Wait. This man was over 100 years. His child is already dying. His wife is already dying. Already dying because she has grown old. Grow so old. His wife was about, I think, 100 years or so. 100 year plus. Why is 112 years or something like that? Both old. And God spoke to Abraham and said, Abraham, sacrifice your son to me. I beg, with even your normal sense, we tell you that you won't do it, right? But this man never said no. It pains him. He takes his side there with faith. He takes it to the mount. The side say, Father, what are we going to use as a sacrifice? He said, God will provide. But in his heart, he knew he's going to kill his side that day. He has a side that whether he's going to die like that, as an old man with that child, he has the side. The man took the side there to the pool and said, my son, I have to tell you the truth. You are the sacrifice. And he said, sir, you want to kill me as a sacrifice? Besides, the Abraham said, I have no choice. God said I should sacrifice you. And the child said, Father, I love you so much. Don't disobey God. Kill me. You see that? Can you take your son or take your child or daughter and said, I want to kill you? And your daughter will say, hey, wait till you talk, sir. I won't kill you. You want to kill me? Uh-huh. In fact, I know the children of nowadays will be the first person to go and take knife and say, daddy, if you can come near me, I will shoot you. I will shoot you. If you come near me, I will shoot you. Because these are the era we have. The eras of disobedience children. But in those days, even the son of Abraham told his father, kill me. Obey God. And Abraham look at it. I watched a video. That video was so touching. Abraham was touching kissing his son. He hugged his son. He cried. He hugged his son, but he said, son, I have to kill you. And he laid his son down and he hold the knife like this. He sharp the knife. And he hold his son's neck like this. Twist it like as if he wanted to kill a fowl. He twist it like this. And he put the knife like this. As he put it there like this. Just for him to, bah! He has already put it there. He look up for him to put the sword. And the voice speak from heaven. And said, stop, Abraham. Abraham, stop. And that Abraham and that it's not about hearing that voice, but that voice was an authority that angered. It was stop. And God said, truly I know that truly you loved me, you obeyed my way. And God make a covenant that he has never made with any man on earth, and that covenant is still in heaven. What am I trying to say is that how many people, how many are you people who can obey God's will? But this is the problem of the whole matter. Number one, if you do not obey God, there is no way you will make heaven. If you did not obey God, there is no way you will make heaven. There's no way. There is no way you will make heaven. The will of the Father will come in a very hard area. It will come as if it is too hard to obey. It will come as if, Lord, what is this? And these are the will of the Father. In the book of Matthew chapter 5 verse 48, open it. Matthew chapter 5 verse 48, it said, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is what? Is perfect. This is the will of the Father. Be ye perfect in your deed. Be ye perfect in your conversation. Be ye perfect in your word. Be ye perfect in everything you do in your life. Be ye perfect. And what is the perfection? Holiness, righteousness, obeying the will of God, restitution. You know, restitution is too hard, but that is the will of the Father. Restitutions, and so on like that. But this is the matter he said. I'm going to tell them, even though they said on that day, Father, we prophesy in your name. Father, we preach in your name. Father, we say so in your name. Father, oh God, Father, we do miracle in your name and wondrous wonders. And he said to them, I will show unto you the path for me. I know it to you. I know I do not know you. And he said, it's not he that calleth me Lord. Lord, that we make the kingdom of God, that we enter the kingdom of God, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is a follow peace with all men, without wish, follow peace with all men, follow peace and holiness with all men, follow holiness and peace with all men. Be ye holy as God is holy with all men, and without wish, 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 no man shall see the Lord. No man shall see the Lord. How many of you want to see the Lord? If you want to see the Lord, then follow peace with all men. Live a holy life. Live a righteous life. What I'm going to tell you now, I want you to start thinking when you are eating, think about God. You must come to a level. You must come to a level whereby even they come and put gun on your head, you will not be afraid. And you will tell them, sir, I will not obey your will. I will only obey the will of God. It's once people die. People will die once. When they shoot you on your head, you say, shoot me that gun. Please pull the trigger. Pull the trigger. I'm ready to obey you. I'm ready to obey you. When they say, we are going to cut off your neck, if you refuse to accept Islam, you tell them, I am ready to die because I will not obey that message. Malatu sekete, I will not obey that Islamic message. I am ready to die for God because the will of the Father is what I will, what I will do. I pray you will do the will of the Father in Jesus' name. I pray you will make heaven in Jesus' name. I pray you will not go to hell in Jesus' name. Don't forget what I said. The will of the Father is hard to do. That will might come in a place of you preaching the gospel. That will might come in a place of you. God might tell you, go and preach to your master. Go and preach to your boss in your working place. Go and obey it. Obey that way. Because if you do not obey that way, you are not doing the will of God. God can tell you, go and take a bell and begin to ring bell in that country you are. Meanwhile, in that country, it's not permitted for you to ring bell and preach. But that is the will of the Father. Do it. If it will eventually lead you into prison, accept it. Let it go into prison. If it will take your children's life, do it. If it will take your life, do it. Make sure you obey the will of the Father. It was whoever it will take from you. If that will of the Father, it will take your clothes, your wardrobe clothes, all your cloak, and it will allow you to go and burn it. Better go and burn it so that you can make heaven at last. If it will take you to remove your beauty and make you ugly, better do it than for you to go to hell. I pray you will not go to hell in Jesus' name. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you so much. Yeah. It is well within the mighty name of Jesus. We are rounding up the program. The will of the Father. The will of the Father. How many people here will do the will of the Father? Let me see your voice out. You will do the will of the Father from today. Aha. Let me see your hand. Let me see your hand. Let me see your hand. You will do the will of the Father from today. Let me see your hand. Yeah, that's good. As from today, no matter what it will take, even though it will take your marriage, you will do the will of the Father. Let me see your, begin to wave the hand. If truly you are going to do the will of the Father, wave it now. Even though it will take your life, you will do the will of the Father. Yes. Wave your hand. Wave it. Let God see you. Let God see that you are waving the hand. You will do the will of the Father, no matter the condition, no matter the trial, no matter the pains. Father, begin to pray. Because I will do your will. I promise you. Ye palimbra da shiaba. Even if you do my beauty, even if you do my money, even if you do my energy, I will do it. Yes, now. Talk to God. The will of the Father. Marapateke tempredeto. Ruske pele pranda kalia katusia. Talk to God. I will do the will of the Father. It will take me to take all my shoes away and burn them. It will take all my eyelids away and burn them. It will take all my makeup away. Are you waving your hand? Are you waving your hand? Are you praying at all? Are you praying at all? The will of the Father is what I will do now. I will do it just the way they are doing it in heaven. Marapatoske nibara. Lebranta pila passion de ka rapaku seketembele rusen de kralu sepe rapatu skembele tiada. Open your video and talk and say, I will do the will of the Father. Maratendo sianda pa. I will do the will of the Father. Open your video and talk. I will do the will of the Father. Talk to God. I will do it now. No matter the condition, no matter the trials, no matter what happens, I promise I will do the will of the Father. Marapate sikelia katulia. I will do the will of the Father. Just talk to God now. I will do it now. Lord, I promise. I will not go back. I will do your will, O God. No matter what we happen, no matter the condition. I will do your will, O God. No matter the condition, I will do your will, O God. Speak to God. Can you please speak to God? I will do your will, O God. From my heart. From my soul, from my mind, I will do your will. I will not go back. Marabatangeta yikata, Mendes Rosianda Posa, Rakaposi andapa. Yes, Lord, I will do your will. Oh, my Lord. I will do your will. Marabatende basiala posa. I will do your will, O God. I will do your will. Wave the hand now. It's a art of making a promise to God. Open your video. Malapesa de capanda posa. Menabramba de cabarabaha. Ye santa pariba se tecalia. Metallica takata. I will do your will, O God. I will do your will, O God. My Father. Limanama Shangusilia. Makuse Papakabala Katia Natusa. Mabarabatiatu. Ipilipa Shikada. Marotepe. I will do your will, my Father. I will do your will, my Lord, my Maker. I will do your will, my sincerely Father. I will not go back. I'm promising. as from today, worldly film, I will not wash. I will not wash worldly film again. I will not wash worldly film again. I will not use article again. I will not use powder again. I will not use powder again. I will not use makeup again. I will not use all the things that can make me physically offensive to you. I will not use them again. Trouser is no more in my life. Oh Lord, miniskirt, I will not do them anymore. I will not do them anymore. I will do the will of you, O Lord, to make heaven at last. I will do your will. I will do your will. Father, show me mercy. Just as the way they do your will in heaven. Give me the grace, O Lord. Boyfriend, I will not have it anymore. I will go and break that relationship of my boyfriend and my girlfriend. I will break that relationship. No matter what it takes me now, I will do your will. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Our everlasting Father, I give you all the glory, all the honor, all the adorations. Put that hand up so that, I give you all the glory, all the adoration. I pray for everybody as we are raising up our hands to say we are going to do your will. We are saying that we are going to do your will. We are raising up this hand and saying we are going to do your will. No matter what happens, no matter the cases, no matter the conditions, your will is what you are going to do, O Lord. We are saying, Father, we will do your will. We are putting our hands up now. We are putting our hands up now. We are making a pledge today to you, Jesus, that the will of the Father is what you are going to do. We are not going to do our will anymore. In every condition, we do your will. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Yeah, God bless you. The Lord be with you in the name of Jesus Christ. So please, before we share the grace, today is the Sabbath day. Try and pay your tithe and offering. If you don't have the account number in your hands, text me. I will send it to you. Do that. And this week, we are going to hold our fasting as usual, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You know that we used to fast every week. So, and the topic of our fasting for this week is, you are going to pray about writing your name in the book of life. Tell God, please write my name in the book of life. Mark me as a candidate of heaven. Write my name in the book of life. Mark me as a candidate of heaven. That is our prayer point today. I mean, this week. So make sure you do that. The Lord bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. It is well with your soul in Jesus' name. As I've said earlier, don't forget what I said. That the will of the Father is what we should do. Tonight, we are still going to have our prayer, normal prayer, which we used to do every night. That is 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Deliverance hour. Invite your friends, people who are passing through serious problems, serious trials, invite them home and let them be aware. I pray we all make heaven in Jesus' name. God bless you. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with every one of us now and forevermore. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Don't forget, for the fasting,
I think it's Monday to Friday, sir.
Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. That is our prayer, our fasting.
Oh,
fast and pray. Don't forget the will of the Father. Let it ring in your the will of the Father. The will of the Father. Bye bye. Bye.
Apostle, please, what time is the fast? What time the fast, please?
We start morning early, 6 a.m. early in the morning.
Okay, please. Thank you.
Anytime. 3 or 6, as you have the ability to fast. God bless you.
Midday 3 or 6. Okay, thank you.
Yeah. God bless you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.